What if I told you that strict emissions laws forced Bosch to secretly evolve the legendary K-Jetronic system, years before K-Jetronic appeared? Today, we uncover the missing link of fuel injection history, KU-Jetronic. I started studying KU-Jetronic for months out of pure passion. That journey quickly led me deeper into the worlds of K-Jetronic and KU-Jetronic. The more I learned, the more I realized. These systems, despite their complexity, are beautifully logical, durable, and incredibly important. Let's start with K-Jetronic, Bosch's mechanical continuous fuel injection masterpiece from the 1970s. It's purely mechanical, no electronics, just precision metering based on airflow. If regularly driven and maintained, K-Jetronic can last virtually forever. Major maintenance involves replacing the fuel injectors approximately every 90,000 miles and the fuel accumulator, the most expensive part, sometimes costing as much as $500. Once replaced, the owner can enjoy another 90,000 plus miles of reliable service. Simple, durable, timeless. But in the early 1980s, simplicity wasn't enough anymore. California's strict emissions standards demanded cleaner engines, and Bosch had to evolve the mechanical K-Jetronic into something smarter, without losing its legendary reliability. And KU-Jetronic was born. KU added a Lambda sensor to monitor oxygen levels, a frequency valve to fine-tune fuel injection, a basic 9-pin ECU to manage real-time corrections. It was still mechanical at heart, but smarter. The KU-Jetronic ECU had 9 pins in total. 6 of them directly handled injection control functions like Lambda correction, frequency valve operation, and idle switching. The other 3 pins supported related systems like the OVP relay, secondary air injection, and idle speed control. Pin 2 picks up the Lambda signal itself. Pin 4 powers the heating element for the Lambda sensor. Pin 5 grounds the throttle switch. Pin 6 reads the throttle position at idle. Pin 7 communicates with the idle speed control unit. Pin 8 receives power from the overload protection relay, OVP. Pin 14 controls the air injection relay. Pin 15 links to the diagnostic connector for reading frequency valve operation. Pin 16 connects to ground. Six pins controlled fuel corrections, and 3 pins supported related systems like idle control and OVP protection. Because the ECU was now electronically sensitive, Bosch added the overload protection relay, the famous OVP. But they already included a fuse to protect against surges above 22 volts. Early OVPs were simple 4-pin designs, 30 for battery power, 31 for ground, 15 for ignition, and 87 to power the ECU. Here's the built-in protection fuse inside the early OVP relay, a small but critical line of defense for the ECU. When the OVP relay fuse blows, the ECU loses power. The frequency valve stops working, no Lambda corrections. Sometimes the idle speed control unit also loses power, depending on model year. ABS warning light comes on in the instrument cluster immediately. If the OVP fuse blows, the ECU can't function properly anymore. You'll often see the ABS light staying on as a warning. At the same time, the car becomes hard to start, whether hot or cold. And if the weather is frosty, the engine might refuse to start at all, because cold start enrichment relies on electronic signals protected by the OVP. When the OVP relay fails, the ABS light warns you. But hidden behind that are major drivability issues, like poor starting both cold and hot, and no Lambda corrections, especially dangerous in frosty weather. Now that the ECU was protected, KU-Jetronic could finally control the air-fuel ratio more precisely, and some truly legendary cars began to use it. KU-Jetronic wasn't a temporary fix. It was the foundation for modern fuel injection. It showed that electronic feedback and mechanical precision could work together, and it changed automotive engineering forever. KU-Jetronic wasn't limited to Mercedes alone. This system powered some of the most iconic machines modified for the U.S. market, including Mercedes-Benz W116, W126, or 107, Ferrari 308 GTS, Lamborghini Countach, U.S. versions, DeLorean DMC-12, Volkswagen Golf Mk1. All these legends secretly ran KU-Jetronic, using Lambda feedback to meet American emission standards, sacrificing performance a bit. So next time you see a California-spec Mercedes, Ferrari, Lamborghini, or even a DeLorean, remember, behind the scenes, KU-Jetronic made it possible. Tuners later discovered a hidden secret. By adding a simple manual switch to the frequency valve ground, you could force the valve open, enriching the mixture during boost. This type of paddle-style toggle switch is commonly used in automotive applications, including air ride suspension systems. It's a simple on-off switch that can handle 12-volt circuits, making it suitable for manually controlling the frequency valve. To manually control the frequency valve, identify the two wires connected to the frequency valve. One wire typically receives 12-volt power from the fuel pump relay. The other wire is connected to ECU pin 15, which grounds the circuit to activate the valve. Install the manual switch between the valve's ground wire and a good chassis ground. When the switch is on, it provides a direct ground path, causing the frequency valve to stay open continuously. This manual control of the frequency valve is only suitable for experienced tuners who know how to properly calculate the correct air-to-fuel ratio. If you activate the frequency valve without adding extra air, for example, without a turbo or supercharger, you'll simply flood the engine with excess fuel, causing rich running, rough idle, and possible stalling. Remember, if the air volume remains the same and only fuel increases, the mixture becomes far too rich for normal combustion. Used carefully, this trick can provide a simple form of boost enrichment. Used carelessly, it can cause serious drivability problems. In boost setups, the Lambda sensor and catalytic converter are disabled because they would otherwise fight the richer mixture and cause back pressure. On the left, factory KU, balanced for emissions. On the right, modified KU, focused on performance. While KU-Jetronic added smart corrections, KE-Jetronic took the next leap. Instead of a warm-up regulator, KE used the Electro-Hydraulic Actuator, EHA, allowing instant differential pressure adjustment. In K and KU systems, differential pressure slowly rose to 1. 8 bar over about 4 minutes. In KE, differential pressure is instantly adjusted by the ECU, holding around 0. For bar right from startup, unlike the rebuildable WUR, the EHA cannot be repaired. Replacement is the only option, and cost can exceed $500. Meanwhile, a full WUR rebuild kit costs about $90 and restores original performance affordably. Bosch's fuel injection journey mirrors the evolution of automotive engineering itself, from simple mechanical perfection to emissions-focused hybrid solutions, to real-time electronically assisted control. KU-Jetronic may be forgotten by most, but it paved the way for the future. If you enjoyed this deep dive into rare automotive tech, hit like, subscribe for more hidden stories, and as always, happy Mercedes-ing.